Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a very good morning.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.
Sudah lama kita tak bersiaran ya. So today we are going to discuss on topic 4.5, which is the true pentagram. Okay. So maybe I will talk about double integral a bit when talking about these three pentagrams, but double tu actually embedded lah dalam triple ni, okay. So I hope you already watch the videos so that you may understand more if I discuss on this exercise directly. Okay, there are 8 questions altogether in this exercise 4.5, so I may look into all the questions one by one lah. Okay, so ada 8 saja. So kita tengok je lah satu. Okay, question number 1 to 3 is actually just an integration technique. Okay, to evaluate the iterated integral. So there would be, I think, no problem as long as you know when you want to integrate with respect to one variable. You have to treat all other variables as constant. Dia macam differentiation. Okay, tapi ini adalah integration kan? Okay. Okay, for question number 1, kalau you tengok limit dia, the limits are all constants. Okay. Sorry, soalan dulu. Okay, you have a limit for x is from 0 to 1, limit for y is from 0 to 2, and z from 0 to 3. And then you have the integrand xy plus yz plus xz. Okay. Okay, so if you find integration where all the limits are constant, so if you change this order of integration, katalah you nak tukar. Sebab untuk triple integral, you have 6 options for the order of integration. You ada 6 pilihan. You sama ada you nak buat dx, dy, dz ke, dy, dx, dz ataupun dz dulu, and then dx, dy, so on lah. Okay. Okay, so you have all these 6. Okay. If sekali lagi saya ulang, kalau dia punya limit is a constant, then you may, if you reverse this order of integration, you may as well reverse the order of the limit accordingly. Okay, maksudnya, kalau dia tukar dy, dx, dz, sekarang y adalah kosong kedua, so kosong kedua tu mestilah ke depan. Polos eh. And then the x must be, x is from 0 to 1. And then the z is 0 to 3. You boleh tukar macam tu saja. Okay? Provided that limits are constant. Okay, this is one ni eh. Ada yang tanya saya macam mana nak reverse order of integration. Okay? However, if the limits are not constant, okay, maksudnya dia ada variable 0 to x squared, 0 to 2, 0 to 3. Walaupun hanya satu. Walaupun hanya satu. Okay, so kalau you nak tukar dy, dx, dz, y ni tadi 0,2 kan? 0,2, x, 0, x kuasa 2, z, 0,3, cara ni salah. Okay, you tak boleh tukar macam tu saja. Okay, you can only change the limit according to the reverse of integration if the limits are constant. Itu saja. Faham eh? So, ini you can ambil ni lah sebab reverse reverse the order of integration ni penting. Okay. Okay. Now let's solve the integration. So first, integrate respect to x means your y and z are constant. So you solve the inner integration first, okay? So, bila tak solve lagi yang Y dengan Z tu tak solve lagi kan? So, you tulis lagi limit dia masih ada. Means the limits are still there, okay? X mean X squared over 2 Y. Y still ada sebab dia constant, okay? Attached to the X, so still macam tu juga. And then Y, Z. Y, Z now, dua-dua adalah constant kan? Okay, dua-dua adalah constant but then we want to integrate respect to X. So, you tambah saja X, Y, Z. Okay, macam saya bagi dalam you punya WhatsApp tu eh. Apa beza dia apabila benda tu hanyalah constant dan benda tu ada attached with another variable. Okay, you have to look back into your WhatsApp lah. And then the Z is constant, however the X is the one we want to integrate. So X squared over 2Z. Okay, substitute the value for 0 to 1. Okay, and then 0 to 1 is only for X. Other variable you jangan kacau lagi. Okay, because the 0 until 1 is for X only. Okay, and then minus 0. So 0, 0, 0 will be 0 lah. Okay, you don't have to write down the minus 0. Now, the second integration is for y. Okay, again, this is half z. Half z is only a constant. So tak ada y, letaklah y saja. Okay. And then substitute the value is for y only. Okay, jangan kacau z tu lagi. And then substitute 0, everything will be 0 lah. Permudahkan laman yang boleh permudahkan. Okay. Last will be integrate respect to Z. So, dia ni dah satu jadi Z. Tambah 2Z kos 2. This one also Z kos 2. Yeah, this is actually boleh digabungkan dan 2 tambah Z will be 3. Okay, saya simplify lah senang. Then you will have 33 over 2. Oh, sama macam jawapan buku, 16 apa? 16, 1.5. Okay, so actually you have to do one by one. Itu sajalah untuk question number 1 until number 3. Lepas kita continue with question number 2. So again, we integrate respect to x first. Then substitute this value is for x only. And then it has 1 over 2 right, saya bawa keluar senang. And then integrate respect to Z. And then this value is for Z only. Okay, there has 1 over 3 or so here. So, 3 darab 2 dapatlah 6, 1 per 6 bawa keluar. Y, masukkan Y, dapat Y kuasa 3 and then tambah lagi Y, so dia ada Y kuasa minus substitute z equals to negative 1, you will have negative 1 to the power of 3, which is negative 1 also, so negative y. Minus negative y minus negative negative will be positive. Okay, this one also you have to substitute, but then it is 0, so 0 plus 0 will be 0, so saya tak tulis lah, okay. Tapi jangan lupa, kalau it is other than 0, then you have to substitute actually, okay. So you have the answer, 7 over. Okay, again, we repeat the step from question 1 and 2. Okay, so you have 1 over 2 here. Dia buat keluar. So, substitute the value is for what? So, x turn, yang kacau. And then, minus 0 will be 0. So, I have x squared and x. So, you have x to the power of 3. Okay, yang ini, dia ada 1 kuasa 2. So, dia ada 4 kan? So, 1 per 4. 1 per 4 darab 1 per 2. So, yang ini dah jadi 1 per 8. Okay. Saya ringkaskan sajalah. Okay, another 1 over 4 times with x, so you ada 1 per 32. Okay, this one, we have 2 power of 2 now. So you may choose to expand or open the bracket, okay? And then again, substitute 0 will be 0, so saya tak tulis. And then use your calculator to calculate for the value. Then you get the answer 1 over 60. Okay, so that's how you do the evaluation of the integration. Okay, you have 3 different variables. Similar to differentiation, if you want to integrate one variable, the others will be treated as constant. Okay? Ada soalan tak so far?
Yes, doctor.
Tak ada? Okay. Now let's proceed with exercise number 4 and 5. Exercise 4 and 5 actually, yeah. Use a triple integral to find the volume of the solid. Okay, and then ada juga tanya saya, macam mana nak cari volume? Apa integral untuk cari volume? So, you have a double integral and you have a triple integral. So, volume for triple integral is 1 dv. So, dv ni yang tadi, dz dy dx, dy dz dx ke, you have 6 options. Okay? Whereby, for double integral, your integrand is fxy. Fxy is equal to z lah. Okay, so this is dA. dA, you have two options, which is either dx dy or dy dx. So these options actually depends on the questions. Okay, if the questions give you dx dy and it asks you to reverse, means you have to find dy dx. Okay, if the questions didn't give you any options, then it may up to you lah. Okay, however, there are choices that will be easier for you to integrate other than the other. Okay, yang itu you kena refer pada region. Region R. Okay, so this one, the region is what we call R. This one, the region we call G. Okay, G is a solid region. Okay, R to a curve, 2D. So this is R is in 2D, well, G in 3D. Okay, so this is different between double integral and triple integral. Eh? So volume nak cari benda sama, tapi kalau guna double integral, awak kena ambil fxy sebagai integral. Tetapi kalau guna triple integral, awak tak payah nak cari fxy tu. Awak terus guna satu. Okay, satu saja. So question number 4. The solid in the first octant bounded by the coordinate plans and the plan. Okay, so kena lukis lah. So kita nak tengok region kita ni. You have to sketch, okay? So your y will be equal to 1 and then your z will be equal to 2. Okay. So you have three options of R. Okay? R ni adalah yang 2D tadi. Saya kata you ada tiga options. Kenapa tiga options saya kata? Sebab the first one you boleh ambil yang ni. Bawah ni. Okay? This one is on the XY plan. RXY. Atau sebenarnya you boleh juga ambil yang this one. The blue one. Which is the R will be projected into YZ plan. Okay, dia project pada YZ plan. Yang tadi project pada XY plan. Tengok daripada atas. Yang ni tengok daripada tepi. And then the other one is you tengok daripada tepi juga, which is here. And then this one is the R XZ plan. Okay, tidak semua soalan tu dia ada tiga-tiga-tiga macam ni lah. Actually depends on the surface. Okay.
Doktor.
Yeah.
Nilai Y tu bukan satu ke? Nilai Z yang patutnya dua.
Oh yeah, saya terlampak Z pula kat sini. Sorry, thank you. This one should be satu, this one should be dua. Thank you. Kita 2X tambah 6Y tambah 3Z. Betul kan? 2X tambah 6Y tambah 3Z. Okay. Okay. So, sekarang ni katalah saya nak ambil the XY plan, okay, to be my R. So, I project XY plan. Saya kena baca ni. So, pada XY plan, tadi dia memotong X tu pada 3, dia memotong Y tu pada 1 kan? So, this one lah. Okay, what is the function of this line? Dia mesti ada function dia kan? XY plan terjadi apabila Z equals to 0, right? So, you substitute this function with z equals to 0, what's left is 2x plus 6y equals to 6. Ini tak payah nak cari semula lah apa function dia, tapi you substitute saja, okay? So if I project my 2D on xy plan, so 2D ni tadi R, saya nak project pada xy plan, so my 3D must be z dahululah, okay? So this one must be z. Okay, yang ini yang R ni, yang dA ni tadi, you boleh ubah dy dx ke dx dy. Katalah saya nak ambil dy dx. Okay, so saya jalan y dulu. So dy dx is from below to up kan, below to upper. So bila saya jalan daripada bawah, saya akan jumpa y equals to 0. This whole line. Okay, and then I will find this line, which is the y equals to. So saya kena ubah equation ini menjadikan y sebagai subject. Which is y equals to 6 minus 2x over 6. Okay, ataupun nak jadi 1 tolak 1 per 3x pun boleh. Okay. So 0 until 1 minus 1 over 3 x. And then your x, okay, hujung sekali ni, limit for the last one must always be constant. Last one saja. They must be constant. So means you just read the value of x, which is 0 to 3. Okay? Then the z, okay, we z refer to your 3D. Okay, so you bak z, paksi z adalah ke atas kan? Maksudnya you jalan daripada bawah ke atas. This is dz. Okay, you jalan daripada bawah, you akan jumpa the plane yang z equals to 0 tu. Plane eh, dia bukan garis, bukan titik. Plane. The whole plane, macam lantai. Okay, plan lantai awak tahu jumpa lantai dulu, which is z equals to 0. Until not 2. Bukan 2. Okay, bukan 2. Sebab kalau 2 tu dia adalah, kalau z sama dengan 2, actually you ada macam ni. Kan? Okay, tapi sekarang you punya plan bukan this one. You punya plan yang ni. Yang 3 ni tadi. So yang condong ni actually you punya z. So z, what is z here? Yeah? So you ambil daripada function ni. Tapi jadikan z sebagai subject. So your z will be 6 minus 2x minus 6y over. Okay, so you have, you get all your limits and your, what is your integrand? Must be equals to 1 lah because it asks you to find volume kan tadi. So, yang you nak integrate kan tengah-tengah tu adalah 1. Faham eh? Cara you nak cari limit untuk satu-satu, untuk triple integral. Because triple integral, you have a limit for 3D and then the rest, the last two integration, the last two integration, the DA is your limit on 2D. Okay. Yang dua tahir ni jangan tengok pada 3D tau, tengok pada 2D. Yang pertama saja you tengok pada 3D. Okay. Means you have to sketch, keluarkan lah. Macam ni, keluarkan. Okay, now let's proceed with integration. So z, mula-mula z tu memang akan dapat terus lah 1 per 2x tu lah 6y per 3 2y dx. Okay. So satu ketika ni saya bawa keluar. Kalau you nak potong siap-siap pun boleh, you nak bawa keluar pun boleh. Okay, it's up to you. Masuk saya potong siap-siap tu, awak potong semua ni lah. Ni jadi dua, ni jadi satu ketika, ni jadi dua. Boleh, tak kisah eh. So, macam saya nak bawa keluar. So you have 6 minus 2x minus 6y. Y. Okay, now integrate respect to y. So 3, 2 will be 3. Okay, so we have to simplify our integrand first. Okay, yang kat dalam ni simplify dah dulu. Mana yang boleh darab, mana yang boleh kena expand and everything. Eh. Okay, yang ini you kena expand dahulu eh. Jangan terus darab 3 tu. Because you have a to the power of 2 here. So 6 minus 3 will be 3 minus 4x plus 2 over 3. Squared plus 2x minus 1 over 3 squared. Okay. Yang lain tu cuba tengok eh. Kalau saya ada tersilap ni. Okay, last one, x minus 2x squared over 2 plus 1 over 3x squared over. Minus 0. So 3 minus 3 will be, so ini boleh potong sebab dah habis. So ini dapat 3, so 3 dengan 3 dapatlah 1. Okay, so your answer must be equal to 1. And then, as I said just now, you ada 3 options for R kan. So yang ini saya cuba the R XY. You may choose to try the R XZ. Okay. RxZ. Okay, so if you choose to use RxZ, so dia memotong paksi X pada 3, Z pada 2. Paksi X pada 3, Z pada 2. Okay, so sama juga tadi. Cuma this one will be the Y is equal to 0. So 2X plus 3Z equals to 6. 2X plus 3Z equals to 6. Because the Y is now equal to 0. Sebab you ambil exact plan kan? Okay. So when you choose exact plan, you must see the 3D must be Y lah. And then the 2D, it's up to you. Either you want to choose DX, DZ or DZ, DX. So katalah DZ, DX. So DZ, DX, you jalan Z dahulu. Tak bawah ni, which is Z equals to 0 until Z equals to 9. Bukakan yang ini jadikan 6 minus 2X over. And then your x must be constant. The last integration, the last limit of integration must be always constant. So 0 until 3. Baca terus yang ini, ini dan ini. Okay. And then for your 3D, okay, you akan jalan daripada paksi y. Paksi y is from left to right. Sini kan dy. Left to right, which is y equals to 0. Yang ada plan tu y equals to 0. Until equation yang sama tapi jadikan y sebagai subject. Okay, taking your y as subject, you will have y equals to 6y equals to 6 minus 2x minus 3z. So y equals to 6 minus 2x minus 3z over 6. So this one lah. 0 until 6 minus 2x minus 3z over 6. So you solve this one. Okay, try. You'll get the answer equals to 1 as well. Sebab dia volume yang sama kan. So volume yang sama dia mestilah dapat nilai yang sama. And then you may also try for Rxy, yz pula. The region for yz which is this y, this is z. Kalau the z tadi dia memotong 2, y tadi dia memotong 1. 1 dapat 0. So what is this function? And what is the limit? Okay. Okay, let's look into question number 5. The solid bounded by the surface y equals to x squared and the planes y plus z equals to 4 and z equals to 0. So Okay, so if y equals to x squared, so you have senyum kan macam tu, by the y. And then the plans, y plus z equals to 4 is when y equals to 0, z equals to 4. When z equals to 0, the y also equals to 4. So actually, you ada satu plan macam ni lah. Okay. So actually, bila you gabungkan, you ada something like this. Okay, so this yang atas ni adalah plan y plus z equals to 4. Yang bawah ni, lengkung ni adalah the y equals to x squared. And then this one is the z equals to 0 in which on the x squared plan lah. So you have something like that. So for this question, you only have one R, one region R yang projection onto the plan kan, which is this one. Okay, your region R is a RXY. Kalau you bawa keluar region R tu untuk in 2D, you akan dapat something like this lah. And then this is 4. Okay. This is your region R. So you may proceed with DX lah lebih senang, DY. DY lebih senang and then DX. DX is constant here until constant here. So let's say we find the constant. So this is y equals to x squared. Satu tu y equals to 4, satu lagi y equals to x squared. So substitute, I will have x squared equals to 4, or x equals to plus minus 2. So negative 2 here, 2 here. So you already find your x and y, which is y is from x squared until 4. So this is volume. This is dz. So this is for dy just now. And then this is for dx. Okay, so let's determine the limit for z. Limit for z must be looked into. This limit, the first limit must be looked into the 3D. And then the last two limits, it is on 2D, which is the region R. Okay, so z here, bila you jalan daripada bawah, you akan jumpa z equals to 0. Until not the z equals to 4, again not the z equals to 4, not the z equals to 4. Z equals to 4 is actually, if you have z equals to 4, so you have the plan macam ni kan. Sekarang ni plan tu dia bukan macam ni. Plan tu adalah condong macam ni, yang macam ni. Okay, so plan condong ni tadi adalah y plus z equals to 4, which is z equals to 4 minus y. Okay, so biasa student dia silap dekat depan tu, dia ambil constant. When they in 3D, dia, 3D pun dia dah ambil constant. Dia adalah constant apabila when your plan is something like this lah, yang lurus saja, bukan condong apa, dia lurus memang pada pada axis tu. Okay, pada axis X ke, pada axis Y ke, pada axis Z ke. Okay, bukan yang condong yang menyentuh kedua-dua axis atau ketiga-tiga axis keseluruhannya. Okay, so when it touches two or more axes, it will be it will be a function, okay, not a constant anymore. Okay, so this is what we want to solve. Let's see. So z 0, 4 minus y. Okay, x to the power 4 now because y squared, y, so x squared squared lagi, so dia akan jadi kuasa 4 lah. Okay, kalau tadi saya tak tulis sebab dia tolak dengan kosong. So when you minus 0, so you don't have to write the 0 value lah because it will be 0 or 6 squared kan. Unless it has a value, then you have to write down, okay, the limit, the substitution. Ini pun sama ya. Jangan abaikan negatif 2 ni ada, so masukkan nilai 2. Okay. So you find the answer to be or it's 17/15, or okay, if you want to write down in terms of decimal values also can, okay, doesn't matter lah, as long as the values are similar, setara, okay, so you boleh tulis dalam bentuk apa sahaja. Okay, so question number 6 and 7 pun sama macam question number 1, 2 and 3 in which you have to calculate only. However, the question asks you to sketch kan? So, saya akan tunjuk sketching saja. Okay, the calculation you have to do it yourself lah. Saya rasa termasalah sebab saya dah tunjuk yang sebelum tadi kan? Okay, means when you want to integrate respect to Z, okay, treat others as constant. Y, treat others as constant. And X, treat others as constant, okay, and your last limit must always be a constant, okay. Okay, z equals to 0 until z equals to y plus 1. This is the limit, eh, saya keluarkan limit tu sebab lukisan dia, sketch the solid must always be refer to the limits, okay, the solid dia mesti sama dengan limit tu. Okay, sketching ni dia bukannya sekali sketch terus dapat bentuk. Okay, you sketch lah dulu, sketch bentuk macam mana, and then you can imagine the correct shape, the correct surface, then you write down the last apa surface tu yang sebenarnya. Okay. So for this one, z equals to 0 until z equals to y plus 1. So I know y plus 1 must be a plan. Kenapa? Sebab Z tu kuasa 1, Y also through power 1, okay? Means it is a plan, there is no X, right? So the plan must be along X-axis. Okay, so contoh you ada plan. Contoh lah, Satu, negatif satu. Kenapa saya tahu satu, negatif satu? So you masuklah bila Z equals 0, jadi apa? Y equals 0. So this plan is actually along this X-axis. Okay, contoh. Okay, tapi kita bukan nak plan ni, eh. Kita bukan nak plan ni. We don't want this plan. Okay, the second one is y equals to negative x until x. So, this is, if I sketch on 2D, actually I will have a full circle, right? Full circle. Kenapa full circle? Sebab yang bawah ni adalah the y equals to negative square root. Yang atas ni adalah y equals to positive square root, and then this is negative 1 until 1, so you ada full circle. So you imagine you ada full circle kat bawah ni. Okay, circle awak memang jari 1. So tadi dia memotong X pada 1 kan, negative 1. So actually this one, dia jadi kita lukis balik, lebih cantik. Okay, so sini satu, sini negatif satu. So sini contoh lah, okay. So you have something like this. Ini menyentuh dia. So this is the y, so the z equals to y plus 1. This is the circle tadi in which projection on the 2D will be like this. Okay, this is your sketching for question number 6. Faham eh? Nampak tak? Dia daripada bentuk macam ni yang pelik-pelik itu, eh? And then you imagine lah sikit. Oh, dia potong ni, dia potong pada, this is the actually the line tu yang potong dari tu. Tapi sekarang bentuk dia bukan garis kan, sebab dia ada bulatan. So dia punya atas ni pun mestilah berbentuk bulatan yang telah terpotong. Okay? You imagine a cylinder, you potong serong. Integration, you may try yourself, eh?
Okay, doctor.
So the limit y is here. So the limit y is here, right? Okay. So bentuk ni, you nak tahu bentuk apa? Kalau bentuk macam ni, you tak nampak lah kan? Sebab it is a square root. Square root is actually half of a surface. What surface it is, you have to square. So bila you square, you akan dapat y square equals to 1 minus x square, which is x square plus y, sorry, y square equals to 1. So it is a circle. Tapi bila dia jadi limit, dia ambil half-half. Kenapa? Sebab mula-mula dia akan jumpa half below. This half below is the negative half. Okay? And then sebab dia jalan daripada y kan? Okay? And then bila dia jalan lagi, dia akan jumpa half yang atas ni, which is this half is a positive half. Sebab tu daripada negative ke positive. It is actually a circle. Okay, question number 7. Again, the integration you made with yourself. Let's sketch the solid. X is equals to 0 until x equals to 2. Y or z. Z is equals to 0 until z equals to 4 minus y squared. And then y is equals to negative 2 until y equals to. So this is actually the limits. Eh? Saya tulis dalam bentuk seperti inilah supaya senang saya tengok daripada mana ke mana. So x is from 0 to 2, y is 0 to 4 minus y squared, y is negative 2 until 2. Okay. So again, at first you may do a sketching, a doodle only, not the correct one, okay. But then lastly, jangan tinggalkan macam ni sajalah jawapan awak. Nanti kan saya tak nampak apa bentuk. Tulis at least dalam bentuk yang boleh dinampak lah, boleh dinilai secara pemberian markah tu ada. Okay. Okay. Semuanya constant kecuali this one, right? Itu bentuk apa tu? If I have my 2D, let's say the my 2D is YZ. Katalah sini Y, sini Z. Z equals to 0 is here. Z equals to negative y squared is masam, tapi ada 4. So masam tu pada 4. Okay, so actually Z tu dia macam ni lah. And then the negative 2 and 2 here. So dia jalan Z dahulu, dia akan jumpa Z equals to 0 until Z equals to this one, which is Z equals to 4 minus y squared. And then the y is from negative 2 until 2. So this is the region R dia. Okay, so kita transform region R ni pada 3D, so ia akan ada macam ni kan. Okay, and then the x equals to 0 is actually here lah, x equals to 0, which is the yz plane. And then the same shape until x equals to 2. So x equals to 2 tu katalah kat sini, dia berhenti sampai situ saja. So this is a parabolic cylinder. Okay, so this is the x equals to 2 yang bentuk lengkung ni adalah Z equals to 4 minus y squared. Yang bawah ni xy plane is Z equals to 0, which is the xy plane. Okay, so ia ada bentuk macam itu sebenarnya untuk question number 7. Okay, last question. Compute the integral fxy z equals to z in the region bounded by x equals to 0, z equals to 0, y equals to x, and y plus y squared plus z squared equals to 9. So z equals to 0. So actually we are getting here. Okay, so we have y equals to 3 here. This is y equals to 3x. Yeah, the way just matching here. So this is the y squared plus z squared equals to 9. And then here is the x equals to 0, yang bawah ni adalah z equals to 0. Okay, so you ada bounded lah. Okay, so you ada dua region R yang you boleh gunakan kat sini. Okay, the first one is here, which is R projected on the XY plane. The second one is here, which is R projected on YZ. The exact tak ada kan? Exact dia tak ada menyentuh pada exact plan. So, you tak boleh nak ni lah. Okay, let's say. You choose the one on the YZ plan. So, YZ plan. YZ. So, the X tadi, X is from 0 until Y over 3. So the Y is from, let's say I choose to work from Y dan dulu, so sini Y kosong until this one is Y equals to 9 minus Z squared square root. And then the Z is from 0 until. ZX. Okay, so actually, I don't have to write this down when I already integrate the limit. So I have 1 over 2 here. Minus 0, so we have 27 over 8. Okay. So this is when I project on YZ plane. So you may try the projection of RXY. Okay, projection on RXY means you'll have X and Y. Okay. You ada Y sama dengan 3X, this one kan? And then, dia ada motong sini 3, Y equals to 3 here. So, this is Y equals to 3X. So, this is your region R. So, you boleh carilah Z and then DZ dahulu. And then, let's say you want to choose dy dx ke df dy ke, it's up to you lah for this two. Okay? So, if your Y is, if you choose dy dx, so your Y must be from 3x until 3, your x is from 0 until you have to find the value here lah. Okay, what's the value there? And then z is from 0 until that one, which is 9 minus y squared square root. Okay, you have to find this one. And then the answer must be the set, which is 27 over. Okay. Okay, so actually the projection for the region R is not unique. It depends on the surface, your surface. Okay, if you look here, the projection on the XZ plane tak ada kan? Sebab dia tak ada menyentuh pada XZ plane yang you boleh nampak kat situ. Okay, so that's it for three-point integral. We will continue with cylindrical spherical afterwards. Okay, dan minggu ni mungkin kita dah tak ada kelas lah sebab besok you start with your quiz and then we are going to have a holiday for the new year.